I've taken you mind, body, and soul.
Look at the Undertaker.
You're helpless against my ministry.
They've lashed Stone Cold Steve Austin to that Undertaker symbol.
Tonight, our journey stops in your purgatory. I will sacrifice you to the Ministry of Darkness.
The only thing left is to bury you alive.
The gravesite is prepared for the buried alive match tonight on pay-per-view. Who will be entombed under a mountain of dirt? Will Stone Cold's championship future be buried tonight as well?
For that warm Canadian reception. At the risk of repeating myself, I would like to once again state that there is no chance in hell that Stone Cold Steve Austin will ever again be the World Wrestling Federation champion. Well, I know many of you are saying, well now, Mr. McMahon, you said that Austin could qualify tonight for the Royal Rumble should he win this match. That's true. I won't go back on my word. However, I would suggest to you that Austin himself, as well as his hopes to qualify for the Royal Rumble, will be literally buried alive in this tomb by The Undertaker at Rock Bottom pay-per-view tonight.
Nearly a ton of dirt. A tombstone that weighs in excess of 3,000 pounds.
And as far as The Rock is concerned, despite the condition of The Rock, this pay-per-view tonight in Vancouver is dedicated to The Rock. Dedicated to the best damn WWF champion there's ever been. Dedicated to the corporate champion. And as such, it is only right that all of you pay homage to The Rock here tonight. May I have a drum roll, please?
Well, what is this all about?
Ladies and gentlemen, we pay tribute to the World Wrestling Federation champion, The Rock!
Display, some would say, but there is a major story regarding the
one
Rock's
thing
physical
that confused
condition.
The Rock crossing the border last night. Rock couldn't understand why it said welcome to Canada and bienvenue au Canada. What is that? Two different languages saying the same thing. You people here in Canada can't make up your mind whether you want to be French or whether you want to be English. He can't speak either language very well. There's no doubt you have a tremendous identity crisis. The French hate the English, justifiably. The English hate the French, justifiably.
So much for the corporate subtleties from Mr. McMahon.
You want to be French, you want to be English. All of you, for some reason, are you really proud to be Canadian?
Well, both French and English alike seem to know one word.
No, you're not. Why don't each and every one of you do the best thing you possibly can do? Tomorrow morning, renounce your citizenship. Tomorrow morning, there should be a mass exodus from this country as all of you get on your hands and knees and crawl all the way down to Washington, D.C., the nation, indeed the world's capital. And once you're down in Washington, D.C., you then should be recognized. You should ask for what you really want. Because there's no question that all of you Canadians, all you really want is to be recognized as United States citizens. And speaking of America, I now would like to introduce you to a real American, my very own son, Shane McMahon.
Well, Shane McMahon, introduced by his father, Shane will be joining me for commentary here on Sunday Night Heat. Inflammatory words from Mr. McMahon, but he cannot deny the fact, folks, that The Rock is in some physical peril. We will talk about that situation here in just a few moments. Perhaps the acts of a desperate mankind may have changed the corporate complexion. Shane, welcome to Sunday Night Heat.
Oh, Kevin Kelly, welcome to my show, man. It's nice to be back. What's going on?
Thanks for having me. We got our first contest set to go, but what a night it's going to be. There's a huge story about The Rock as well.
The Rock, man, let's go. The corporate champ. We're going to get into that a little bit later. Let's go, Kev. Here we go.
All right, the Job Squad.
Cole contest is scheduled for one fall in a 20-minute time limit, and it is for the World Wrestling Federation Light Heavyweight Championship. Being accompanied to the ring by the Job Squad from Baltimore, Maryland, weighing in at 210 pounds, is the World Wrestling Federation Light Heavyweight Champion, Dwayne Gill.
Dwayne Gill set to defend the Light Heavyweight title, a real Cinderella story, surrounded by his Job Squad family, Al Snow, Bob Holly, and Scorpio.
You see those guys, the Pasadena Chargers? I mean, Dwayne Gill, this is Cinderella story, absolutely.
Well, they at least know how to follow a winning
and
season going undefeated, unlike the Cowboys. Or excuse me, unlike the Broncos.
Jeff Hardy.
Well, let's talk about
North
something
Carolina,
very, very important. I know the Hardy boys are about to come out here. But you know what? Let's talk about the striptease match. So confident is Deborah that Jeff will win tonight's matchup at Rock Bottom, that Deborah is backstage right now. And Deborah, I got a little question for you. I'm feeling a wee bit Randy, baby.
Well, I don't know who Randy is, but I do know that Jeff is going to be Goldust tonight. And I just want to give everyone out there a little peek at what they're going to miss tonight, because I can tease you, but still please you.
Yeah, baby! Right here tonight on Heat, Kev. Strip tease a little bit from Deborah.
Well, I can't wait to see what Deborah plans on showing us a little later in the hour. But folks, the major story unfolding that could change the complexion of the WWF Championship match. We have exclusive footage courtesy of WWF.com involving The Rock and Mankind that we'll show you immediately following this match. Matt Hardy now starting with the Light Heavyweight Champion. A lot of people saying this is the night the Cinderella story ends for Dwayne Gill.
Oh, nice.
Beautiful neck breaker.
How about that? Right here.
Look at this place, it's packed, man.
Certainly
electricity.
Over 20,000 fans jamming the General Motors place here, Vancouver, British Columbia. It's been sold out for months, and what a night it is going to be.
Nice going up.
Look at this
Powerbomb
now.
Powerbomb maybe, no. Crucifix!
Well, he's got him.
Oh, yeah!
Down in the powerbomb.
Good night!
This one should be over. There is no job squad at ringside.
What's he doing?
They were sent back by the referee. Now going, look at this. Beautiful plancha. Somersault off the tip. Wait a minute.
That's it. Oh, that's,
look at this, the blue meaty. What is he doing here?
Oh, man.
DDT. There he goes. Wait a minute. There's a cover. Two. I don't believe this again.
What a way to kick off heat. The blue meaty.
Here is your winner and still World Wrestling Federation light heavyweight champion, Dwayne Gill.
Check this out, man. Dwayne Gill pulls out another one.
The meanie strikes again. And folks, what a wild way to kick off what promises to be a tremendous night. We want to welcome you once again to Sunday Night Heat. Shane, we will see here in the hour as we head towards rock bottom, Triple H going one-on-one against the LOD's drives.
And one thing we really have to take care of is that dastardly attack on the WWF's corporate champion, The Rock. Mankind came in, the coward that he is, attack. We're going to have that exclusive shot coming up next.
We will have that for you in just a few seconds, folks. What is The Rock's condition, Shane? The champion is in peril.
We'll find out.
Welcome back to the Boppin' Game Center. I'm Michael Cole, and last week's show can only be described in one way.
I dropped my granola bar. Anyway, it was excellent, excellent.
Well, this week's show is gonna be even better. Here's George and Adam.
Not now, guys, we're in the middle of a heated game.
George, look, water buffalo just hit your car.
Ah, don't burn it dead.
Okay, well, joining us now to play Bop It, Kai and Ty.
Bop It.
Succeed!
Well, I guess they're going to have to brush up on their English. Folks, we'll see you next time on the Bop It Game Center.
An ominous darkness sort of fills the General Motors place here in Vancouver, and we welcome you back to Sunday Night Heat. We're minutes away, folks, from the start of Rock Bottom live on pay-per-view. But Shane, The Rock tonight will also defend the WWF Championship, the Corporate Championship against Mankind. But that championship match, the entire complexion has changed based on what happened earlier today.
Well, again, earlier today, that coward Mankind, in cowardly fashion, that berserk Mankind came flying in and attacked the Corporate Champion.
Let's show you what happened earlier today involving The Rock and Mankind.
Rock, it can't get any better than this. I mean, you're the WWF champion and you have a pay-per-view named after you.
Exactly. Well, first and foremost, Michael Cole, not too many times does a Rock let a jabroni like you stand this close to him, but it's all right. It's all right, Mike. You can stay here. You know what? The Rock drove the corporate caddy into General Motors place this afternoon, and all the employees of this great arena were standing around saying, "Hey, Rock! Hey, champ! Go do your thing!" The Rock cracked a smile, and he said, "Shut your mouth, you pieces of trash!" And you're right. It doesn't get any better than this. Michael Cole, life-size color pictures of the corporate champ, life-size color pictures of the great one. It's going to be The Rock here tonight. 20,000 of The Rock's fans all chanting his name. Do you smell it?
Well, Rock, with that said, can you concentrate tonight on your opponent, Mankind?
Mankind? Piss on Mankind. That's exactly what...
Welcome to the corporate party, Rock! Welcome to the party! There's a white guy, Rock! He must be a corporate guy! Smell what he's cooking, huh? Can you smell what he's cooking? Can you smell it? Let's watch that! Here's a corporate elbow, Rock! And a corporate table, too! This corporate, whatever the hell this thing is! Come on, Rock! Come on! And a corporate rhododendron for the champ! This isn't a rhododendron. Son of a the corporate ribs.
Easy,
okay. Doc.
You know what? This is a couple of broken ribs here. I'm sorry. There's no way you're going to work it tonight.
What do you mean?
No.
The Rock couldn't agree with you more. Do you hear that, Vince? Now then, go tell that jabroni Mankind that he just screwed himself out of a title shot. Easy, Doc.
Take it easy, Doc, will you please?
Oh, tell him, Vince.
I'll tell him. Take it easy.
Take care of this issue. Easy.
You don't move, please.
It's a corporate ribs, for Christ's sake.
Wait a minute now. wonder what Mankind thinks of, is thinking about hearing that news.
Well, again, the corporate ribs are hurt. There's no way. That.
Which, keep, wait a minute. What's Mankind doing now? Looks like,
oh God. That was the arena, I saw the arena.
It looks as if, where is he going? Well, folks, Mankind is obviously beside himself, mentally anguished because of Team Corporate's attempts to break the man down at every turn, robbing him of all of his possessions, including the Hardcore Championship most recently.
What are you talking about, Kevin? We always gave Mankind opportunity. My father has treated Mankind like a son.
Oh, you set him up to knock him down, though,
Absolutely
Shannon.
Absolutely not.
On.
Come on, let's go.
Well, certainly Mankind, I mean, he's speculated openly about his chances tonight here at Rock Bottom. But a dangerous, desperate Mankind is certainly dangerous and desperate enough to do something drastic like he just did to The Rock earlier today. Oh, wait a minute now.
I'm out of here. Keep him away from me. Keep Mankind the hell away from me.
The man who will battle The Rock tonight. Shane?
Yeah, I'll be right with you, Kev. You handle the, podcast there, buddy.
Obviously, Mankind causing many tense moments for all the members of Team Corporate. Speculation now about the physical condition of The Rock. Doctors apparently telling The Rock he will be physically unable to compete tonight.
It is a happy day because, Vince, I have an early Christmas present for you right here.
Well, it's definitely not a leaf blower.
You see, Dad, you taught me very well. You taught me to read the fine print. And the fine print of this contract says that if The Rock should fail to wrestle tonight for any reason, the title becomes mine, mine, oh,
what?
Mine!
How about that news?
Something, no, that's
now,
wrong.
Now, Dad,
that's wrong.
Maybe you'd like to play Let's Make a Deal. If you'd like me to erase that little clause in my contract, then maybe you and I should have a father-to-son talk. What will it be, Dad? Will it be what's behind door number one, or what's standing behind the lovely Carol Merrill behind the curtain? It's all up to you, because Vince, you and I both know that you have something I want. Have a nice day.
Obviously, Mankind holds all the cards in this deal. If The Rock is unable to compete, Mankind will get the WWF Championship.
No, that's what you call a forfeiture clause.
Forfeit the title. There ain't no way The Rock forfeit nothing.
Is The Rock's time as champion coming to an end?
Vince will take care of this.
Why are we doing this?
Mr. Where? McMahon.
The forfeit. Is that the way Mr. McMahon talks about it? I'm the Rock. The Rock is the champ.
Mr. McMahon.
Okay, no, listen. Okay, now you have to take care of your ribs. No,
you're
please.
Right. You're right. You're
okay,
right.
Okay, come here. Come on.
Don't worry.
Corporate ribs. That's what I'm saying. Go get Mr. McMahon.
Well, as you can see, The Rock cannot believe what he heard. The announcement from Mankind. And how will Mankind's desperate actions impact the title match tonight at Rock Bottom? Could the corporate champ have to forfeit?
I don't know. Actually, I don't know what to say, Kevin. But absolutely not. The Rock will not forfeit. My pops, he'll take care of this.
Being accompanied by Scott Too Hot Taylor.
Well, too much said for action. Last week, of course, it was reckless actions from Draws that has left Scott Taylor now on crutches, Shane.
Yeah, check it out. Last week right here on Sunday Night Heat, Draws, this is how you get ahead in the WWF. Make a name for yourself. Wrench those ligaments in right out of the knee there. Beautiful, Draws, beautiful.
Well, doctors have said that Shane is going to be on those crutches for quite some time, so Brian Christopher's going to have to fly solo for now.
I'm Shane. I'm not on crutches. I mean, Scott.
Scott Taylor. Well, Brian Christopher just dedicated the match to his partner, Scott Taylor, who is joining us now for commentary. And folks, while Scott Taylor gets loaded up to talk about this match, I want to let you know that Heat is brought to you by M&M's, blatantly exploiting the new millennium.
And also by Sports Field Games, a real fishing experience from Tiger.
And by WWF The Music Volume 2. Experience your favorite WWF original jams. On sale now at all Coconuts, Record Town locations, and other fun retailers.
What's the dealio? What's up?
What's up, Kevin Kelly?
Scott,
what's up, Shane McMahon?
Too hot, baby. What's going on? Oh.
How does that dedication make you feel?
Man, that touches my heart. I can't tell you. That's my best friend.
Nice.
That's, oh, what a move.
Well, you know, speaking of tag team partnerships, you know, most guys come in and they're working together and they work towards one goal. But you know, I can see the interaction between you two. It's a much more personal relation. It's a very, I don't know, a super type, extracurricular type thing, even outside the business.
What are you insinuating, Shane?
Nothing. I'm just saying you guys are always together.
Maybe every other tag team in the World Wrestling Federation should have the bond that Too Sexy and Too Hard have.
Nice tackle there by Kevin Quinn, who now goes up and over the top. Ryan Christopher, great agility. Nice.
Maybe if the Legion of Doom have the bond that Too Much has, they wouldn't be having the problems that they have right now.
Well, speaking of problems, you know, this is newcomer Kevin Quinn.
Oh, yeah!
Belly-to-belly suplex, and Ryan Christopher on the receiving end right now, Scott.
Beautiful. Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
A little overzealous there.
Man,
take it easy,
you man. You guys don't know what an honor this is for you guys today. You've got one of the best-looking wrestlers in the world in the ring. Well, you have the other one sitting right beside you.
Oh, nice. Check out that power bomb, man. Brian Christopher, you have to say, is taking care of the newcomer as of right
well,
now.
Folks, the action continues to heat up on tonight on USA. Next, when Bobby seeks revenge for his parents' death, will he cruise out of control? Nine with the pack on an all-new Pacific Blue. Then at 9, an art thief is making the rounds in Palm Beach. And Tom's new flame is the prime suspect on an all-new Silk Stockings. And then at 10, Michael is missing. Can Nikita rescue him before it's too late? Petta Wilson is La Femme Nikita. Don't go anywhere, son. Oh! He continues right here on USA.
Oh, my.
That's Petta Wilson there, Ken.
Well, it's got to trouble you, Scott, to see your partner on the receiving end.
Yeah, it troubles me to see him on the receiving end. This stuff doesn't usually happen to him.
Let's go. Oh, nice.
Apparently, your injury causing a little lack of focus, I think, maybe, for Too Sexy.
Look at this kid, Kevin Quinn.
Look at that.
Oh, wow. Rookie move
going
right there.
For it all. And Too Sexy able to throw Kevin Quinn off.
That's why he's one half of the best tag team in the world.
Oh, face Quinn. Oh, nice.
Wait a minute.
Nice move.
One, two.
He got it. Oh, what an upset.
Look at that.
Here's your winner, Kevin.
What an upset. What an upset. Now, how does that make you feel? Your partner dedicated the match to you, Scott.
That wasn't supposed to happen like that.
That was beautiful. Give it up for Kevin Quinn.
That wasn't beautiful, Shane McMahon. What's wrong with you? I used to like I thought you were pretty fly for a white guy, but I guess not.
That's bull crap. Perhaps you two should talk about this.
You guys are going to work out your differences.
Private moment or something.
It.
The members of Too Much are beside themselves. The upset scored here on Sunday Night Heat. Kevin Quinn has defeated Brian Christopher.
Nice dedication.
Wait a minute now. DX is on their way. The Outlaws defend the tag team titles tonight against members of Team Corporate. Triple H to take on drop.
Oh, yeah. Check it out. The commission, the corporation, baby.
Wait a minute. Woo! I think it's getting set to explode out here.
Oh, yeah. Showdown time.
And now, the WWF Rewind presented by Glover. New for Nintendo 64 and PC CD-ROM. Gotta love the glove.
Badass Billy Gunn took the chair, looked like he was going to hit Triple H, and he clocked Shamrock. I don't think Helmsley and X-Pac even knew. I can't believe it. D-Generation X has pulled the wool over the eyes again of the corporate team. Michaels has been double-crossed.
That was the WWF Rewind presented by Glover. New for Nintendo 64 and PC CD-ROM. Gotta love the glove.
We are back on Sunday Night Heat. Rock Bottom begins at the top of the hour live on pay-per-view. The Buried Alive match, Stone Cold Steve Austin and The Undertaker will take a tour of that. Still to come.
Oh, boy.
You think it's what you are. You think that you're better. But you better get ready. Bow to the masters. Tell me what to do.
creation of Team Corporate. You know, the Outlaws made a career mistake. They didn't join the corporation. Membership definitely has its privileges. And to quote a great person here in the World Wrestling Federation, my boss, you can do things the easy way, or you can do things the hard way. Outlaws chose the hard way.
And,
so be it.
And for their deeds last week, the Outlaws, courtesy of Commissioner Shawn Michaels, have been ordered to defend the tag team titles tonight on Rock Bottom, folks, against the Big Boss Man and Ken Shamrock. Certainly a tall order.
That's the payback, baby, because the corporation needs a little tag team gold.
We'll see Triple H in action momentarily against Draws from LOV.
Now, well, hopefully, well, check that out, man. That's awesome. Awesome. Feel this power. Feel that electricity.
What a sight, folks.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Making his way to the ring, being accompanied by Animal. He weighs in at 272 pounds. Legion of Doom, Draws.
Hopefully, Draws can do the same thing to Triple H as he did last week to Scott Taylor. Rip that already injured knee, or the recovering injured knee, of Hunter Hearst Helms, Triple H.
I'm a little surprised you take that strong of a position, but certainly Draws did show a killer instinct last week.
Yeah.
Triple H is going to have to be mindful of that in this one-on-one contest. And we want to welcome everybody who's joining us here tonight on Sunday Night Heat. Folks, Rock Bottom begins at the top of the hour, and everybody's going to be tuning in. Want to let those of you that have never ordered pay-per-view before let you know just how easy it is. Quite simply, all you got to do is call your local cable or satellite provider. Their number is on your last phone bill.
Check that out. Check out the clock. Rock Bottom begins in a little over 25 minutes.
Draws starts off very quickly. And folks, remember, ordering Rock Bottom could be as easy as the interactive system, Shane.
That's what my buddies have in Greenwich. They got the satellite. They're watching the pay-per-view. They'll be watching.
Get yourself locked in, folks. Order Rock Bottom now. We will take a tour of the gravesite for the Buried Alive match in just a few moments. Triple H flattened by Draws, who has started off very quickly.
Draws, what an animal this guy. No pun intended there. He's awesome.
Well, a little bit uncontrollable as of late, some would say. Nice float over.
Beautiful.
First lateral press of the match, and Triple H able to kick out at two. Certainly the physical condition of The Rock now taking center stage. Doctors are evaluating The Rock's ribs as we speak. Some doctors are telling The Rock to forfeit the match tonight, and that would hand the title over to Mankind.
No, don't worry, I'm telling you. Vinnie Mac, he's got to have a master plan. Ooh. I hope he has a master plan. Oh, hope he's got the master plan. He's going to take care of this. Vince will take care of this. Don't worry.
Triple H now, Irish whip, draws hard to the corner. Oh. Triple H runs into a boot.
You can say that, definitely.
Outlaws have to defend the tag team titles tonight, Shane, against the Big Boss Man and Ken Shamrock. Certainly the members of Team Corporate, I'm sure that Shawn Michaels will enjoy watching the Outlaws suffer in that tag team title match.
Absolutely. A little payback, baby. Like I said, tag team gold is needed in the corporation, and it comes home tonight at Rock Bottom.
Oh, no.
Oh, boy.
The boot to the midsection, set and ready to deliver the pedigree. Triple H looks incredible. He's definitely on his game. This one is over.
Here is your winner, Triple H.
The momentum definitely on the side of DX for now. But later on tonight at Rock Bottom, folks, the Outlaws defend the tag team gold against members of Team Corporate. Animal kind of, it's a little disgusting to Draws. Disappointed, I'm sure. You gotta wonder how far Commissioner Shawn Michaels will go in trying to destroyed DX, obviously still harboring a lot of bitter feelings.
Oh yeah, well, check it out. Talking about bitter feelings right there between Animal and Draws. Look who just came in for dinner.
Oh well, wait a minute now, up the aisle.
I can see that right here from where I'm standing.
DX, you might as well celebrate now because it's gonna suck from here. Tonight at Rock Bottom, during the tag team title match, DX will be barred from ringside. What that means is China, Triple H, if you stick your nose in anybody's business for any reason, the New Age Outlaws will be stripped of the tag team titles on the spot.
Beautiful.
Oh, the power of the pencil, Shawn Michaels.
New Age Outlaws.
Worse than ever.
I gotta hand it to you, boys. You pulled a fast one on old HBK. But you know what? As the power guy, I am bulletproof. So to show you that there are no hard feelings, before your tag title match at Rock Bottom, I'm gonna give you a good warm-up match right here on Heat. Now, hit my music!
Well, that isn't fair at all! Blockbuster announcement for the commissioner, Shawn Michaels, folks. What is Mr. McMahon's reaction? Will Pops indeed take care of it? We will hear from the WWF owner next, right here on Sunday Night Heat. We welcome you back to Sunday Night Heat. Standing by with us now is the owner of the World Wrestling Federation, Mr. McMahon.
Well, hold on, let me take on the question here. Pops, I got a question for you. What's up with The Rock? Is he going to forfeit the title?
Please. The Rock is definitely not going to forfeit the title. I mean, come on. It is going to require a little negotiation on my part with Mankind, but I would suggest that the intellectual quotient, or lack of it, with Mankind suggests that he's very akin to a normal Canadian fan, so therefore, I would suggest to you I'm very likely to reach Mankind, whether it's wherever the hell it is, wherever he is at the moment, somewhere in the bowels of the building. Unaccustomed as I am of the bowels, I'm sure that we'll come to some sort of agreement. I have no doubt.
Thank you very much, Mr. McMahon.
Check that out. Every time I see that Buried Alive match, that's awesome. Someone's taking a dirt nap tonight. Is it Taker or is it going to be Austin?
All right, folks, Jeff Jarrett and, well, Deborah is on her way to the ring. She has some interesting news for us, apparently. This whole situation between Goldust and Jeff Jarrett started last week. The striptease act began first with Goldust there with the flash-a-rooney for Miss Deborah.
Oh, yeah, the mind games, absolutely. Goldust is a master of the mind games, tossing D-Lo right there, 1, 2, 3, on Jeff Jarrett.
Yeah, but Jeff, certainly Deborah had a retort of her own for Goldust a little later on. She wasn't shy about showing the,
Yeah, but Goldust is unaffected by Deborah's puppies. So I was going to see what's happening tonight. Striptease match.
Jeff Jarrett, Deborah, awfully confident it seems, heading into the striptease match against Goldust at Rock Bottom.
Michael Cole, confident is not the word, because when it's all said and done tonight, and I beat Goldust in this very ring, he's going to have to strip buck-ass naked. Just look at her. Look at her, Michael. Do you think I'm going to let everybody in this building tonight get a look at that perfect body?
Yeah. Yeah.
Show them, Deborah.
But I'll tell you one thing. There's definitely one present that will stay wrapped.
Boy, Southern Bell, baby.
Well, the wrapping paper could get shredded, left on the floor. If Goldust indeed defeats Jeff Jarrett, will Deborah have to strip tonight at Rock Bottom? They may be confident, but certainly Goldust is very confident in his skills as well.
Absolutely, man.
Woo! All right, folks, as an added value to tonight's Rock Bottom pay-per-view event, just simply send in your cable or satellite bill to the address on your screen, and you'll receive a WWF bandana. Folks, you still have time to order Rock Bottom on pay-per-view. It's really easy to do. Call your cable or satellite provider. Maybe you've got the interactive system. Just hit that button. Either way, lock yourself in to Rock Bottom. And of course, the Buried Alive match, Shane. Stone Cold Steve Austin, his title future depends on this match tonight against The Undertaker.
Well, we could be looking, well, we are looking at someone's tomb. Who's going to be cast inside it?
We look outside the crown jewel of Vancouver, the beautiful General Motors place, which has been sold out for months and is home to WWF Rock Bottom in your house, which is being brought to you by Glover, new on Nintendo 64. Gotta love the glove. Rock Bottom is tonight, live immediately following Heat on pay-per-view. Is it a reversal of fortune for The Rock? Standing by right now with the WWF champion is...
Hold on a second. The Rock's gotta chill out. Let The Rock chill out for a little while. Don't be rushing Rock doing anything. You know, check it out, man. You know, the pent-up anger between Austin and Taker is gonna be unbelievable, and someone, it's something, could end up catastrophic tonight.
Federation has never seen.
Wait, look who's here! The Undertaker's here! The Undertaker's got a shovel! A shovel!
with a shovel.
After competing in a match in the San Jose Arena, he blacked out.
Austin, at January's Royal Rumble, you will be one of the 30 participants. All you have to do, Austin, is defeat The Undertaker in a buried alive match.
You don't hit me in the head with a shovel, lay me on a damn table, and try to embalm me.
Please, no, no.
When I get my hands on Paul Bearer and The Undertaker,
they both got hell to pay. Can you believe that Austin just broke the end of that shovel right off of The Undertaker's face?
They both got hell to pay.
What is Stone Cold Steve Austin fixing to do to Paul Bearer now? Paul Bearer been stuck in the sewer. My God, he went head first into the sewer.
Give me the hell yeah.
A buried alive.
Buried alive.
Austin, you are helpless against my ministry.
In the ministry of Stone Cold Steve Austin at Rock Bottom, you can bet your ass that you can expect no mercy.
I can take your rotting soul anytime I wish.
Buried alive match.
That's what's in store for you. You're getting a glimpse into your future right now, Steve Austin.
I will sacrifice you to the ministry of darkness.
What I'm going to do is pull that foot out of the grave and put it in your ass.
Austin, burn in hell.
You're not going to be content until Steve Austin's career is over.
A buried alive.
What are they doing to him?
What the hell are they doing?
At last, Stone Cold Steve Austin to that Undertaker symbol.
Austin, I've taken you mind, body, and soul. The only thing left is to bury you alive.
Somebody gotta help me! I've never seen anything like that in my life!
Tonight, one of those two superstars will be buried alive. This grave is 8 feet long, 4 feet wide, and 6 feet deep. This tombstone weighs over 3,000 pounds. This mound of dirt, over 2 tons of dirt surround this grave. This dirt is cold, it is dark, it is wet. Can you imagine being shoved into this pit tonight, having 2 tons of dirt thrown on top of you, gasping for your last breath, crawling to get out, gasping for that last breath? This is not a match for careers. This is a match for your life.
Oh, you didn't know? Your ass better call somebody. You damn right. Oh, HBK thinks he's getting the last laugh. He says he's bulletproof. He'll think bulletproof. Now put a hole in his monkey ass.
Outlaws having to quickly get dressed. Shane, not only did Commissioner Shawn Michaels order DX to be barred from ringside for their title match later on tonight on Rock Bottom, but it also continues here on Heat.
Oh, absolutely. A little tune-up match.
Music.
A little tune-up match.
Hardly fair.
Oh, it's a brilliant plan by the Commissioner. Brilliant. Bravo, Shawn. Bravo.
Oh, boy.
And look who it's against! The Acolytes! These guys are wrecking machines!
These guys are barely even dressed. Billy Gunn is still adjusting his boots, and Farouk and Bradshaw are heading to the ring. The Acolytes have brutalized all of their opponents so far with no regard for the rules.
Here we go, yeah!
Whether they're ready or not, the Outlaws have to face this tune-up match against the Acolytes.
Excellent, Sean, excellent. I can't wait to come back in my high tent, HBK.
Well, Commissioner Michaels obviously showing he's still stinging from being drummed out of DX back on March 30th.
I know, he wasn't drummed out of DX.
Please.
Come on.
Well, the Acolytes now, both of them have a hold of the rope off, and they're not going to let go. Farouk and Bradshaw, as I said, folks, have been absolutely awesome in their physical onslaught of the World Wrestling Federation.
Uh-oh. That's it, ref. Keep Billy Gunn out of there. Oh, check it out. Rock bottom. Oh, under 4 minutes. 3.5. Oh, man, no!
Folks, you got to wonder who will be buried alive tonight. We got a tour from Michael Cole of the very gravesite, Stone Cold's quest for the WWF Championship. Ryan's on that. Or will Austin 316 perhaps derail the Undertaker's Ministry of Darkness?
I don't know. We're 3 minutes away, though. Who's it going to be? Is it going to be the Undertaker, or is it going to be Austin that is encrypted in that tomb and buried alive?
And what are The Rock's chances at defending the WWF Championship tonight?
Oh. Excellent, of course.
Well, Rock now, excuse me, Billy Gunn now being brutalized in the far corner. Road Dogg coming in. The Acolytes care not for the rules. They don't care at all. They're not listening to the referee.
It doesn't matter. Again, give it up for Shawn Michaels.
Boy,
back
oh boy.
There, poised. He plans out everything. He is very, very methodic. Excellent job by the new commissioner.
And the fact that in just a little while, folks, on Rock Bottom, the Outlaws are going to have to defend the WWF Tag Team titles against the Big Boss Man and Ken Shamrock. Oh! This beating, courtesy of the Acolytes, really courtesy of Commissioner Shawn Michaels, is not assisting their title opportunity at all.
Oh, wait a minute.
Look at this.
Speaking of which, yeah, come on down, boys.
The Boss Man.
Beautiful.
This was a setup all along.
Oh, this gets better by the minute. Beautiful.
And
that's it, Ken. That's it, Ken. Get in there. That's it, Boss Man.
Well, you know, DX, certainly, I guess they are paying for that tag. Now, wait a minute. Here comes Triple H.
What?
Triple H coming down.
What are the Acolytes doing?
And now the Acolytes are pounding away on Shamrock and Boss Man.
What the hell is going on?
Is this part of the corporate plan?
No, HBK, get out here, please. What is going on here?
I doubt this is what the corporation had in mind.
Yo, Shamrock, get out of there! Boss Man, get out of there! Save your strength!
Oh, wait a minute! What an ominous presence! You can feel the mystical energy!
Austin! Tonight, we write the final chapter of our journeys down the highway to hell. You will reach rock bottom tonight. I've claimed your soul. Tonight, I claim your very existence. Each day that's passed, you've grown weaker as my ministry has grown stronger. Upon this stone, I shall build my ministry.
Oh! Oh! Wow! Yeah! Next Rock Bottom will be a pay-per-view!